According to a report from Jeff Snyder at the Tracking Board, a sequel to Eddie Murphy's classic 1988 comedy, Coming to America, is confirmed and moving forward at Paramount, hiring original writers Barry, what looks like Blaustein?
Blaustein.
Blaustein. Yeah. Damn, did you guys see that? Did you guys see me just kill that? And David Sheffield to pen the script. Murphy recently teased a sequel on his Twitter feed before removing the tweet and his account when he claimed the account had been hacked. TMZ then followed up finding out that a movie was in development, with Snyder finding out that the project is now in active development. No release date has been targeted. Josh, do you buy or sell a sequel to Coming to America with the original writers penning the script?
Oh, man, this is a... I don't like this idea at all. I was so on board with a Dumb and Dumber 2 because I love those characters so much, right?
Right.
I was extremely disappointed. Same with Zoolander 2, but the trailers for Zoolander 2 look so ridiculous that I was like, no way this is going to be good.
Mm-hmm.
Coming to America might be one of Eddie Murphy's, if not... Listen, obviously, Beverly Hills Cop is his franchise. I mean, that's what made him an international megastar, right?
Yep.
But Coming to America might be his funniest comedy, and it's because
Absolutely.
It's smart,
yep.
and it's Eddie Murphy, and that generation of people found that very, very funny. I'm included. This generation could go watch Coming to America and be bored by it. This I know because it's a different kind of comedy. Mm. And what they're going to do, just like they've done with all these long-term comedy sequels, is just jam cameos down their throat. You're going to have Randy Watson in Sexual Chocolate. They may have gotten a big single, and now they're millionaires, and they live because, like, that wasn't good. They're going to go to the barbershop, and maybe some of the guys have died, and they got young guys in there. Arsenio Hall is going to make a cameo. I'm sure the McDowell's has been taken over by a McDonald's, and now the guy has to run a McDonald's franchise, or he's trying to start his own thing. Like, I could write this movie, and it sounds worse in my head than I'm actually saying it right now. It's just a cameo fest, and I just don't think that works with the Coming to America franchise. The best line in that movie is, thank you, fuck you, you know, like,
yes, fuck you too.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That stuff wouldn't fly in comedy these days. It's going to fall flat for today's audiences, and it's a shame because the original Coming to America is simply genius. And that's my rant. I'm sorry.
I'm with you. I'm with you. I didn't know how to feel about this. It broke pretty late last night. I had to put it in. They've been talking about it for a while in a tweet. Eddie Murphy deleted his Twitter account because he kind of broke the news on there.
Oh, no.
And then TMZ goes in and kind of finds out that it's actually happening. So we've been hearing about this. I didn't really put much stock into it until they got the original writers, and they're obviously moving forward. And yeah, you think of Zoolander 2.
Yep.
You think of Dumb and Dumber 2. And I don't know. I think you nailed it on the head, Josh. It's going to be a lot of like, hey, remember the other movie?
Yes, yeah. Yes.
And what was so great about Coming to America is the heart in that movie.
100%.
It was so, I mean, when Akeem would like kind of pull back and not be Eddie Murphy, and he's like, one must not learn to walk, must one learn to fly, or whatever he says.
Right.
It's like this like profound statement as he just took out a robber with a mop handle.
Yes.
It's so well done. There's outlandish things, of course. There's great cameos by Eddie Murphy and then, you know, Randy
Watson,
Sexual Chocolate.
Even the woman in the
Chocolate.
Western Union Telegram, which she signed it, semi.
Yeah,
like, semi.
Why not make it a cool million?
Yeah.
You know, there's so many wonderful parts of that. It's just, it's following another trend where they're trying to go recapture that magic and get some box office dollars.
There's a reason why that movie was magic, is because time of release and the time in Eddie Murphy's career. Since then, dude, what, the last 5 or 6 years since the Dreamgirls movie, Eddie Murphy has been pounding sand one movie after another.
And look, Beverly Hills Cop 4 has been in active development hell.
Yeah.
It actually is in hell. It like scripts here, scripts there. They're from everything I've heard and all the research I've done, the scripts have not been great. He can't figure it out. Then he tries to make a Beverly Hills Cop TV show. Doesn't even get a pilot. It's canceled. So there's something going on that it feels like he's going to Coming to America. Oh, Beverly Hills Cop didn't work? Well, here's Coming to America. And it just feels a little desperate. I don't like it. Am I going to see it? Probably. Because I love Coming to America so much, but man,
I'll wait till you guys go see it.
Yeah, they really have to find a good story. They got to find that heart. Why? Because it troubles me to think that Akeem went to all that trouble to find his queen, and then we get a second movie,
and
they're divorced. I don't know if that's going to happen.
Come on.
But that's just speculation, but I don't know. Roka?
I buy it.
I buy it because I like that the original writers are coming back.
It's a good sign. I'll give you that. It's a good sign.
Eddie needs a hit, and sometimes you stick around long enough, you come back. That's just how it works. That's why people make up these weird terms that end with Renaissance. You know, it's these things that happen.
Someone took a shot.
Someone said, "No, I'm
taking a shot."
No. I read last night. Someone did. Kid Manassant. Someone was trying to for Nicole Kidman again. I was like, Kid Manassant. She never left. So it's just these stupid things.
She just got nominated for a freaking Oscar.
I know, right? This is stupid things like that. But like, so to me, I'm kind of encouraged because Eddie deserves a hit. Eddie needs a hit. You know, with Charlie Murphy dying, sometimes there's like, you know, there's like this place where you like, sometimes the universe conspires to bring you up. And I think it's time for him to have something here. And I'm excited for it. I don't trust Jeff Snyder. He's part of the Patriots. I don't believe anything he says. No, I'm joking. No, so I was excited that he broke this. And I was initially, I have the same thing. I have trepidation because of Beverly Hills Cop 3, because of some of his other projects. And you're right. Not since Dreamgirls, he hasn't had a really good film. I mean, Norbit, Jesus, what was that all about? And the terrible stuff with whatever he did last year, he was the chef. He didn't do it. But I've seen Eddie in interviews. Eddie when he goes on the talk shows, he is an engaging, funny, still incredibly intelligent guy. And you were absolutely right. Coming to America is the zenith of Eddie Murphy as a comedian. This is one of the best films. And it showed you, like you just said, Mark, that Eddie could really act. He could play vulnerability. He could play levels in films. Yeah. And so this is the launching pad. And he's great in Dreamgirls. He got robbed for that Oscar by Alan Arkin and Little Miss Sunshine. Give me a break with that crap. And so to me, I think Eddie kind of deserves one last hit maybe before we close the book on his possibilities here in Hollywood.
Schmodown promo here for you guys. What is the name of Eddie Murphy's kingdom in Coming to America?
Zamunda.
Correct. I mean, not to compete with Bobby Zamunda.
There it is. All right, guys, that'll do it for our buy or sell segments.